that's the name of the game.
Just sometimes I have a brain. I can't hold it anymore. I lose my cool.
Brandon, you think you're the only person in the world like this? I don't know of an individual who is not in the same predicament. Even the wisest of men is in the same predicament every second of their life. You bet. Spell cool backwards and we think of loss.
Lost? Lost your life? Lost your life? Lost your what? Life?
What do you do with the lock? I think I can keep God in.
Lost God?
You can't keep him in, you can't lock him in. He's air. And what are you trying to think and call yourself? Cool air or hot air? He knows exactly when to pull himself like a plug out from the plug. And let you experience what it is to feel the moment of taking your first breath. Every second he puts you there to wake you up. But you don't own anything, you don't have anything. But yet, you are entitled to everything when he decides you won't get it without any effort.
Well, that's what she was saying, no effort, and you're saying we always
have
the last laugh in the end.
Yes, I'm laughing the last laugh because it's effortless.
But you said in the effortlessness, you have to have an effort constantly.
That's right. See that sign there? Read what it says. Yeah, see the stairway to it. It's going from the bottom to the top. Read the first.
I know the first structure.
What does the structure represent in a person?
The body.
Look at that thing. It's there,
the
printed.
Sperm thing?
Get it clear in your head. Failure.
Oh, you're a winner.
If I put the word failure into its right perspective, everybody would stick talking about it.
What is it? Not
living?
Hi.
Hi. Hi, have a nice day. I will. I bet I do. Good.
Yesterday?
Oh, yeah.
Trip. Oh, I'm wide awake.
Your brain.
Wide awake.
I'm wide awake. I'm wide awake. That's the only way to be. See, failure is only feeling all internal lies, urgently requiring experience.
Where I am today.
And that's why the word failure is what it is.
Good. That's what I did yesterday. I wrote down all my failures and I made it forward and all my failures.
See, F is feeling, A is all, I is internal, L is lies.
That'd be a good t-shirt.
U is urgently, R is requiring, E experience. So there's no such thing as failure, but C, success.
I have one said success and one said failure.
That's what I want, this is what Colin make the other one. And the colors I have for failure is the inverse colors.
I like that. Show you.
Success is the structure. Unlimited creativity, coexisting, evolution, service and sharing. Then you realize success is a process of living. Just as much as failure is a process of thinking.
Failure is a process of thinking.
The man who straightened my head up a long time ago. Thank you, Mr. Ray. That's what somebody says to me, I don't know. One of these days I'm going to ask you, you ask what color comes to my mind when I think of the incident, I just tell you rainbow. I say, you sure you want to tell me that? You get freaked out with the answer. Do it fine.
What was the answer?
Your phony like hell. You don't want to admit it.
You what?
You're phony like hell, but you don't want to admit it.
What's wrong with that? I mean, just
because knowing could, it would never happen to
me. Right. But you said something else before. All right, dear friend. Some rings pass, not. Polonium cloud. There's a chemical ring, there's an electrical ring, and there's a magnetic ring. That makes up creation. And they don't pass over each other. When you come to the chemical ring, that's the planetary rate of chemistry. You slide through that into the electrical ring, so you lose all association with chemistry, and you end up in an electrical field. All to stay with that phenomenon.
You stay in it?
You can only stay so long till you begin to lose control of your chemistry. And then you may slip into the next ring called magnetism. So you can't stay in them.
Because you
don't have no feeling.
You don't.
And the life is not for dead skin. Life is for sensitive skin. That's why you say you come back to be a human being again.
It makes you more sensitive, though, becoming infantile like that. What? Well,
so you slow yourself down back to chemistry.
It's fine.
And that's why they call you a human. So they call you a human.
I'm just going to go to the grocery store. And if it happens to me at night, I'm going to say, all right, Lord, but I don't want it. I want a good night's sleep.
Very good. I buy that. I would buy that.
I would keep Teddy in his crib. And Donna, when are you going to start sleeping by himself?
Don't nurse him at night.
Well, that's yeah. That's where he likes to nurse him at night.
That's why he keeps awake.
But don't nurse him at night. Maybe
she just wants him to sleep.
Give
by
him some
himself.
Peanut butter milk.
Even what?
Peanut butter in the bottle.
Uh-huh.
Mix the peanut butter, add a little distilled water, make milk, and then drink.
And then he'll sleep on
film. Okay, yeah. How
do I go?
That's the way I go.
Okay. Mm. I'll be there.
Drop by and see us again.
Don't forget the car
okay.
In there on the floor.
Oh, 85.
Yeah, okay. Yes.
It's right inside.
Come over, we meet you.
Either way.
All right. No.
I don't know the time I'll be back from Dallas, but
no.
It should be 5 or 6.
All
right.
Bye.
Bye.
If what?
If you
were
designed to eat meat,
mm-hmm.
You know, the hydrochloric acid would eat up your stomach.
Why is that?
The hydrochloric acid breaks down every product in your mouth to make it into energy.
Yeah.
It doesn't break down meat. Because it's in your stomach, and what your stomach is made up of?
Flesh.
And so what is meat made up of?
Flesh, I see.
I see. What do you see now?
Well, that's what I thought, but I wanted to hear you say it. Why? I wasn't sure what you were getting at. I wanted to hear you say it.
Well, what's the difference between our hydrochloric acid and the animal's hydrochloric acid?
They don't have the same function like ours. Their designs are entirely different than ours. The length of time that they take is entirely different than ours.
But the HCl is the same, isn't it?
Animals. Who feed on animals have different set of teeth or different set of lining in their stomach with acid in their stomach.
Different acids in their stomach? What acids?
They do that. consume flesh as food. They're designed to phase out the dying creature as a form of recycling. You'll never find a lion as eat a healthy animal. It's highly impossible for her to do that. But you eat a dying animal, a sick animal, or a wounded animal in the process of running that she smells. And she knows which one in the whole tribe, in the whole flock is ready to die because the odor is set off in the air. And she's designed by nature like a undertaker to go get him for food. So the chemistry in her system is designed to break it down so that it becomes a way to leave a perfect economy of disposal and maintenance of this universe. That's why they're called carnivorous.
Carne, meaning meat.
Now we are, what kind of creature? We're carnivorous. That would be perfect. But secondary for us came flesh because of nature's laws of evolution and motion. We evolved through motion and seeds of change. Then tissue flesh became a secondary form of food. It wasn't a compulsory form of food.
It's an alternative.
It was a backup to the change in climates.
A backup, yeah.
When the climate changed, there was no more fruit and vegetables. Mm-hmm. Then the vegetation had gone, and all that remained was the animal. And so man was a slow-moving creature. He then pursued the animal. But primarily he was placed in a garden of a mild temperature where in 365 days he would be exposed to fruit and vegetables like good old Texas.
Yeah.
But he didn't want to stay in a nice warm climate. He wanted to follow the animal because he thought he had to be in open. So when chasing the animals when they were running around, and he started to eat the animals. Now the buffalo doesn't eat buffalo. The buffalo move around graze and went into the areas that were warm. But man didn't do that originally. Follow the buffalo to the warm climate to eat the grapes, the vegetables. He decided that was too long a journey away from where he wanted to stay. He wanted to journey back home, so he decided to eat it to the buffalo and make a pose of the buffalo to keep warm. So fundamentally, man, the only reason he had the animal is because he was all lazy. Ingrained laziness in the man made him eat the animal. If he was never having an ingrained laziness to eat the animal, he would keep on looking for his herbs and vegetables and his fruits, mm-hmm. and never had the problem he got today.
Yeah.
But his ingrained laziness and his desire to stay in one spot and not move around brought him the situation. But by the same token, he would never evolve the way he's flying from there to moon and back. So with all the bad and the good, and all the problems that we've generated,
mm-hmm.
man is the only creature that is going from planet to planet. Maybe we're coming a cosmic little bugger.
Can't we? Aren't we though? Yes. Huh?
What?
I was just repeating
myself. We're becoming the cosmic little bugger.
Yep. That's right.
So that's what they call man now, the little bugger.
Mm-hmm.
The creature that goes around littering the place up. Literally.
Literally.
He has cut down more trees, stirred up more rocks, spoiled up more water, and polluted more air than all the animals could do for the next 10 million years.
in a matter of 150 years.
You know what? I think I'm going to rest for a while on here. After I have a good meal now.
Yes,
this is fabulous. Oh, yeah. Dad, have you ever had a drink of that ginseng rush?
Yes, it's very rushing.
Do you like it?
No, it got some carbonation.
Yeah, I think that's good for you.
I don't believe in carbonated drinks. It makes more carbon dioxide.
And that does. What does that do?
And you don't need it because it inflates you like a balloon.
It what?
It inflates you like a balloon.
Uh-huh. Makes you fatter.
Yeah. I drink ginseng tea.
Oh, ginseng tea, okay. I've got ginseng.
Ginseng tea is good.
Now, what does that do?
That cleans you up and make you have healthy hormones.
Healthy hormones. You know, I called up, what's her name? Oh, Balin. And they said it lowers your blood sugar. And that's all they know about it. Is that right? Does it lower your blood sugar?
If you take it the wrong time of the day.
And the right time of the day is?
Nighttime.
Nighttime? But if you take it during the daytime, it'll lower your blood sugar.
Exactly.
What about in the morning?
Well, men. It will lower the blood sugar. For women, it will raise the sugar in the morning.
What now?
For men, it lowers their sugar in the morning, mm-hmm. and women, it brings their sugar up in the morning.
So it should be taken at night?
By men.
By men?
And at, in the morning by women.
In the morning by women.
And what if a woman takes it at night?
She gets the reverse.
She gets the blood sugar down. Yeah.
Uh-oh. See, the word is very interesting. Ginseng. Men, gin, and women sing.
Men, gin, and women sing. Okay, that's
so
a good way to remember it.
For men, they're ginning around, and yes. Women, in the morning, they sing around.
That's true. Okay, that's a good way to remember. Okay, I've got this with the bark, the little piece of the bark.
Yeah, that's good.
And I've had it 5 years. It's so good.
It's good for women in the morning and for men at night.
And it's still, 5 years later, it's still good, the bark.
Yeah. Now it goes bad. Always keep it improving in age.
Oh, my goodness.
Because it's a ginseng. Ginseng.
What improves about it?
Huh?
What improves over time?
What improves in that?
You said it gets better the older it is.
The potency. The potency of the minerals makes it more efficient, therefore less quantity is used for better results in a short space of time. It's like a homeopathic process where you can use a half a grain if it's 12 years old. You have a result in a matter of a half a minute versus a half a grain 4 years old to have a result in 15 minutes.
That's a big difference.
The older it becomes, the more potent it becomes with the shorter space of time for the consumption of the quantity. And that is the principle of homeopathic medicine. Or raising its potency.
do it like this. Just do it. Do it and then open your eyes. Alright. Oh. Look at that. Yeah. All clear eye after you?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
What did you do? Squint.
You think they want you to do that to make her lose their business?
So if you did that often and that's
what you're that's what the whole thing is for. To make you squint. That's what the Oriental people are called slant eyes. They didn't have no, they weren't born slant eyes. They did, for over the centuries, Confucius was the first man to develop the glasses. So their glasses, China had glasses, they didn't want to wear it. Because nobody wanted to wear it, so they wanted to develop squint practices in squinting the eye.
Oh, Confucius,
that was an origination from Confucius? Yeah, eye exercises, and the Tibetans. But then, after the centuries of squinting, then the people began to develop genetic technique. Like that, squint your eye, slam eye, pull it back up with acupuncture.
Mm-hmm.
And you do like that, you see how well you do like that. Hold. Shelter becomes.
Oh, it's wonderful.
That's the whole, that's where it all came from. But today, now, that takes away from the business of the optometry.
So if you use these glasses long enough, your eyesight will be corrected.
Oh, yes.
Permanently?
9 times out of 10, it may be permanent. 1 out of 10, enough. But 9 times out of 10, it comes back normal and starts over. But it's like an exercise. Remember, it's not a therapy, it's an exercise.
Mm-hmm.
That's why they call it eye exercises.
Huh, what's the difference between a therapy and an
a
exercise?
Therapy is a method that tends to correct a problem, hoping it may become permanent.
Wow.
An exercise is a process applied to keep it functioning as long as you use it.
As long as you... Oh, so you just have to keep exercising. Yeah. As a
process,
and then as long as you keep exercising, it'll work.
That's right.
Hmm.
But most people want therapy, so what? Correct it permanently, and don't do nothing no more.
So lazy. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. And then they go to the guy who can bless you with his hand, and they want it instant.
Ah!
Born blind. If born blind, and they're born blind. You see, they're looking for instancy. You know how to work at it. Well, you know he told them.
It worked though, they got an answer.
He says, he healed them, but he said, we'll sin no more, we'll tell no man. He gave them work to do, because he didn't want to do.
Yeah.
They didn't like that.
I wonder why you didn't want
them
to tell
anybody. Because they boast too much.
They boast?
Yeah, you know people that show off. Look at me, that guy, he healed me. Yeah, look at me, look at that guy.
Oh, I see what you're saying, right.
People are like that, you know. In those days, they have to change to this day. The blowhards and the mohards. There are more blowhards than mohards.
Oh, I heard something real funny last night. This black guy was talking to us. St. Vincent de Paul had a free meal. I told you about it, didn't I? Well, next year, come, it's on Christmas. If your place is closed and you want to cook for yourself, it's at the St. Vincent de Paul Church on the corner of Fulton and Buffalo Speedway. It's really beautiful. It's fantastic. Anyway, this guy, black guy, his name is Warner. And Warner talks so fast. He's, you know, he's an actor. He's thin, wiry, and talks a lot. And he's a stockbroker for IBM. And anyway, he was telling me something about, and he's black, and I said, he said, talk about the good hair. And I said, Warner, I heard that once before. What is good hair? He said, that's straight hair. I said, Warner, believe me, take my father's word for it. And my father was completely bald on the top of his head. There is no... bad hair or good hair. He says there's no bad hair, there's only good hair, and you just be thankful you have it on top of your head. And I said, if you say good hair and say it's straight, That you, that means you're a racist because you say kinky hair isn't any good. Just because it's kinky. And then he laughs and says, well, he didn't think that was racist. But then he's talking about can't you don't you hair. I said, what? This is can't you don't you hair. He says, that hair is so kinky, you can can't you comb it and don't you try it. Can't you don't you hair.
No, you see, the people don't realize, they don't want to appreciate what they got.
Yeah.
Who in the hell can make the hair of a sheep transfer its hair to a horse?
That's right.
Would they change the hair?
No. Just as long as you have it, it doesn't matter whether it's kinky or straight or curly.
Some people were designed by God to be wool.
That's right.
And others were designed to be nothing but horses.
That's right.
So, if he understood that, he wouldn't worry.
Try to explain.
Imagine
a Chinaman.
Warner's cute. Yeah. What can I do for you?
He's not religious.
When would you like to come?
Oh?
Oh, you didn't know that?
Well, the people didn't think about it,
oh.
So they didn't know.
See, there's a very good vision. Pick a piece of paper, mm-hmm. and you cut two lines across, and you stick your coin in and twist it onto the line.
Oh, that's right, like they do in the... Yeah, I've seen, like, when they send you
something. So you stick the coin in between and fold it, like, cut two lines and stick it in, and put it on the line.
Why do they have you send it that way in the mail? Also, it won't move around.
Don't move around.
If it moves around, then what happens?
Then it tears the paper.
Oh, okay.
But this way, it
tears the envelope in here. Okay.
And this way it is held in position and you can take it.
Mm-hmm.
And then it won't move.
Mm-hmm. I want to get my mail out.
Thanks to the ingenuity of the knife. The coin can travel.
Yes.
Have knife, coin will travel.
Let's see.
Now, what is this? Lily, how is your day today?
Oh!
William.
Wonderful.
William.
Donna. Every day is a wonderful day.
I'm glad to hear it, yeah.
Every day.
You really are enjoying life a lot, aren't you, Billy?
Oh, William.
Well,
William.
First of all.
You've got a good job.
William.
Well, no.
William, sorry.
First of all, I'm a winner.
That's right.
Second
you are
of all,
winner.
I'm alive.
That's right.
That's
now,
right.
What else would you ask?
There you go.
Nothing more.
Okay.
Here it is. And if you want something else, they will, I think...
They'll go to Siam for it?
They'll do it. I'll tell you why. They were so cooperative, you and... And they're cooking in peanut oil and ghee for everyone.
Yeah.
Not just for me, for everyone.
Yeah.
As a matter of course.
They use ghee also, huh?
Oh, yeah.
You
because
sure?
I talked to them. Positive.
Yeah.
I talked to them about it toxic, and the man was so interested. And the next time I went in there, I just... You know, sneakily ask, and I asked the waitress, she said, oh, we do it in peanut oil.
Uh-huh.
And she didn't even know me, see, so that's how I checked up that he was doing.
Uh-huh.
I have a childlike boy.
That is beautiful, all handmade.
Mm-hmm.
One, pure one.
It is, well.
Yes, 100% one.
Gosh, where who made it?
The Chiricahua Indians.
In what state are they?
Arizona.
Oh my, and you picked it up. Isn't that nice? And it's all wool.
Yeah.
Is that a rug or what?
Well, it's whatever you like to do.
Yeah, just a placemat or
a
placemat.
A bed or put it on
a floor. You can place it.
Yeah.
Anywhere.
We're trying to help them out to get it themselves.
You place it on the floor, therefore it's a place.
We're trying to help them, you know.
That's right. Oh, thank you. That's so
nice. What were you taking?
It's good for help.
Yeah.
Just bring on any kind of fluids. eliminated.
Oh, red
clover
tea will clean my blood.
Mm-hmm.
And what else?
You take it to the
FC. Take it with the FC. That's what I did. I took it with it. What do you think about herbal life? Three people, right?
Yeah, that's right. Three people and the plant.
Thank you. Three people, and the plant is first, right?
Right.
And then there's
and
two
the male,
people.
The male-female principle is in the middle.
Yes.
And the third one is the unity of them all.
Okay. They look like both, what? Oh, they're not making too much differentiation.
No. You see how the third one has its two hands looking, holding it?
Yes.
Holding one corn?
Yes.
And the two middle ones have one hand each on each corn.
Uh-huh.
And then the corn is the field going all the way around.
Uh-huh.
Oh,
so you see the polarity, plus, minus, neutral.
Uh-huh.
And the whole unity of life. This is what they call the corn dance. Uh-huh. God is a trinity.
Uh-huh.
And it manifests as positive and negative in
uh-huh.
unity.
Uh-huh. Gee, that's interesting.
You see, all three faces look at you. But
uh-huh.
only one has two hands holding a pole,
uh-huh.
or a corn, right?
What does that mean?
That's the neutral. The one to the extreme.
Well, I know it's a neutral only because it's different than the others. But
yeah,
why?
That's the neutral because that's connected with the opposite end.
Yeah.
Of the light.
Yeah.
So it's called that a unified field.
So that's from Flagstaff.
Yeah, and the middle one is called the. Relative field of the plus and the minus. So they call it the corn dance of life. That they have a unified field of spirit between the environment and man. Indians put their ideas in very simple language that you have to understand. We take it and look at it in physics and we see the same truth, no difference.
Mm-hmm.
It is the matter of sensing the unity of life between all things. So they did an artwork to represent it. Plant, man, and the unity between the plant and the man.
Oh, when will second
you?
Oh, Evelyn, it's ready. It's
ready.
Waiting.
You can have this. It's ready.
She said it's waiting, it's waiting. Should I get up on that contraction?
Did you grow up no more?
I haven't been for a long time.
Did you eat how long you had lunch?
It's been
2 hours.
It's been 2 hours.
That's how you do it. The tongue of Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
They make that the name of the restaurant. And they fix up the inside like a street.
Yes.
And they put each post, they put a sign, number one street, number four street, number eight street. They're duplicating the area.
Have you been to the
Juarez is like that.
Yeah, Juarez is beautiful.
They're duplicating
yeah.
exactly where you walk over from this the American side to the Mexican side. The first street in Juarez is like that.
Yeah.
In the middle restaurant.
Right. I was over in Wayne's Juarez. Yeah.
And
then
the guy walks around like everybody does with guitar. He yodels around.
Yeah.
Well, that's a neat way to innovate a restaurant environment.
Oh, I love it. So different.
You can't go to Juarez now. You can go to a restaurant and enjoy Juarez. In New York, it's like that. They have a place called the New York restaurant in back in Chicago. And
mm-hmm.
you walk in and all these things are set up like that. And you think you're in New York,
mm-hmm.
Greenwich Village.
Mm-hmm.
And the middle booths are all like that. And then it's showing the food.
Well, now, where's the American sign thing, the Juarez?
It's on the Juarez side, on the American side. It's on the Juarez side. So the Mexicans are duplicating that on their side.
Oh.
And they call it the American. The border always.
The border.
So you
were, no, but I mean, when you go in the Cafe and Cantina, is there on the American side?
No.
No, it's all Mexico. That's what I thought,
because
I wasn't
here.
I American side.
No, you'd have to go to Mexico to see the American side. It's called the border house.
Huh?
That's the name of the restaurant, Border House.
Mm-hmm.
But that's on the Mexican side. So when you go into the restaurant,
mm-hmm.
it looks like a street on the, in El Paso or Warren or Del Rio or Laredo.
Okay, everyone.
Yeah.
How was the dinner? St. Vincent de Paul.
Oh, good. Yeah.
It was
marvelous. I thought I...
Perfect protein for people who want to eat flesh.
Oh, okay. That's fine. It's perfect.
It was the right kind of a day.
But you see, the turkey still has acid.
Oh, because yes, it's been killed and it gets scared and all this other animals are.
Don't plants get scared when they get pulled out by the roots?
No, they were assigned already. They were assigned already, so they don't have a toxic reaction when you put it into your stomach, even when you cut them and get them ready to eat.
The life force isn't broken.
That's right.
You don't break the life force.
But they do tremble if you go in there and think about pulling them up.
They do not. They were assigned. There's a difference when you're assigned for the human consumption than when you were taken out of your... domicile to be used as human consumption.
Who assigned
them? Everything that moves on the face of the earth, and everything that has seed and bearing seed for it shall be for food and medicine, that's assigned. He didn't say eat anything to fly.
That's right.
He didn't say anything to crawl,
Genesis.
Or walk, or swim.
Genesis.
He just merely said eat everything. That means everything that moves. Now, the word move...
Worms move, don't they?
No, they don't. They crawl. Do not confuse movement with crawl, swim, walk, or fly. That's secondary motions. The primal motion of movement is crystal, stimulated by light, moves by magnetism, which you call plant life. That is movement. That is not crawling, that's not swimming. It's magnetic action between the crystals. That's why crystals keep growing. You can grow your own crystals. There's no end to life.
Does that mean you eat crystals?
What do you think a mineral is? What do you think a...
Well, you wouldn't eat a rock crystal.
What do you think it is? Don't get carried away with the words. You are eating cosmic minerals. 144, 12 basic...
But they have to be in a life form, right? You couldn't just go eat a diamond or something like that.
I eat diamonds 1/100 of a milligram if you give it to me at the right time of the day. I know the quantity that is consumptive and necessary for the humans, a trace mineral quantity. If you don't get it, you'll die of a certain disease. Mm-hmm. So don't go fool yourself that you cannot eat every mineral in this universe. And what is a diamond? It's a highly refined carbon that reflects light. So it's carbon, and you're a carbon-based creature.
Would that be nighttime, the diamond? No, the diamond?
That's the middle of the day.
Middle of the day, yeah.
Why is it diamond?
God, it's caught in the spectrum of 3 and 4 o'clock of the day.
It's, in other words, it's ultimately fossil.
That's right.
So it would, it's traceable ultimately to the middle of the day.
That's exactly.
To what it derives from.
So it is ideal for the small intestines going into the bladder. But you may not know that, and so not for me to aggravate people. But I don't know any mineral. Because I'm a mineral based organism. Come, let us make man. And he said, he says, of the dust, you are the dust. What is dust?
Mineral.
So they have identified all of the dust, 144, and felt it basic, and the rest of trace. That means you got a little specking to survive from the human being. And to have one missing, you can't be a human being.
All of them have to do with renewal. All of them have to do with
a
new beginning.
But the little is so important
to
be human.
In terms of the universe, dealing with the holding us back from here and beginning to let go of that and start something new.
Robert Pennington says it's not always easy to start something new or to let go of the past. And the Kuga satellite wouldn't promote the economy.
We live, man.
Right.
How long is it?
What?
It's hard to tell somebody.
doesn't mean we're all programmed to think that.
Well, is it true? Whether you were programmed or not, is it true? Because sometimes you'll say it's due to my programming, but it would be true anyway, regardless of whether they said it to you or not. So then that's the confusion. Are they saying it to me because it's true, or is it true because it's been programmed?
Yeah, I don't know. Which
that
is
and that's
true.
A question.
Is when the theory does not conflict with the experiment is true.
That's right, I agree with
that. If the theory
that.
Conflicts with the experiment, throw away the theory and keep the experiment.
Right, throw away the theory and keep the experiment. Yeah,
right. Okay. Now when the experiment conflicts with the experiment, you throw away the experiment.
Mm-hmm.
And you keep the what?
I wasn't listening.
Yeah.
Keep the theory until the next experiment disproves it.
That's right. You see? So all wrong, you come out even.
You still got the theory.
You still got the theory. See, that's why it's called theory. D-R-E. Up my nose was little air. Down my toes was a lot of air. If my nose can breathe, my toes can, so I'm stinking the toes and not in my nose.
Oh, my left leg is just...
Ain't that funny?
Mm-hmm.
Now, if I can take my toes and bring it to my nose, it'll make me respect my toes. Because my nose will sure tell me how stinky my toes are.
How stinky there?
Because he couldn't breathe through his toes. But the nose knows. The toes, ain't
it? Right. Yeah, nothing there isn't I did. You are the sunshine.
My only sunshine. You make me happy. Sing a song.
Sing a song, Evelyn. I've been thinking about your singing for
you
since I was here last summer. I've been thinking about your singing.
What's your favorite song you sing?
Yeah, I don't know the words. I just
what
do
you care about?
Carry the
shame. No, it is not to the word, it's the attitude you try to capture. We want to record the joyousness of attitude. You see, you can know the best words in the world and have the wrong
Thank you.
she has a very wonderful voice. She has never employed it in that direction. Mother Hagara.
Yes, Mother Hagara. Bless her heart.
She's a wonderful woman.
They both go to the same cleaners.
Well, Teddy is Teddy's parents are the owner of Picasso's Cafe next to Showbiz Pizza Place on the corner of Wesleyan and
he has an accent, right?
Accent? I don't know. His father and mother are from Mexico City.
Wesleyan and Bessonette.
Yes, of T.
Oh,
you know, yeah. Alan over Showbiz Pizza.
You know that. Something Alan over in Grabber, California, men's, it's a high five men's clothing store. Rather high
five.
I've not seen it.
It's
not real, like,
yeah.
Europe, but
yeah, well, that foundation.
Yeah.
Is that they can buy any object in the store.
Yes.
Without paying the sales tax.
Okay.
Now, anything you give to them,
yeah,
they can keep.
Right.
Provided you write it off as a tax deduction.
Yeah. Sure.
They keep it as a possible applied expense.
Yes.
That you're makes it tax free. Yeah. They don't own anything.
Right.
Now, if they pay you wages to work in that place, you pay income tax.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how it's all over the country.
All right, now, if you go to Rajneeshpuram, if you go to Rajneeshpuram and you work there,
they don't have wages.
You don't get wages. Why not?
Because it's
worship.
Called a cost account service.
I know it's worship.
No, it's called cost account service.
Wow.
Which means that you don't draw wages to make you subjected to income tax.
Mm-hmm.
You are sponsored by the organization that receives contributions
mm-hmm.
that are allowed to be written off as tax deductible contribution by the donor
mm-hmm.
and can buy objects in the public marketplace
without paying sales tax. That's mm-hmm. how it operates, but most people don't know it operates like that and live under the illusion that somebody is getting rich.
Exactly.
Who really gets rich in it? Nobody.
The corporation gets a lot of advantages.
Gets rich. Because if you try to dispose of that corporation, you'll run into a lot of legal hassles in the government. You cannot sell your organization to nobody but another organization who will take it over for nothing.
Are those the only two you have?
Yeah, okay. Well, then what happens when you want to go and buy something?
You don't pay sales tax.
You're not paying sales tax, but you still have to pay something.
You don't.
Why? It's a religious corporation.
You don't understand the law.
That shows you don't understand the law.
Well, just a minute. You're not answering my question because I didn't
know it
right.
There's no tax to pay in a corporation like that.
I know. I know you're not paying tax. Say the thing is 55 cents and 5 cents of it is tax. I still have to pay 50 cents.
Yeah.
That 50 cents is contributed by someone who will sign it off in their check as a donation to which they're allowed to have a deduction on their income tax form.
So as a worker, I just pick it up.
Whereas another thing, way you could put it is there's no such thing as a free lunch, but you don't have to pay tax on it.
Aha, aha, all right. I get it now. That's what I wanted to know. I wondered where would I get. I wanted to know where I was going to, since they weren't paying me a salary, and I was wanting to know where I would pick up the, I wouldn't have to worry about the 5 cents tax, but where would I get the 50 cents?
Well, where were you sleeping in the first place if it's not sponsored? You couldn't go there to sleep. You couldn't go there to eat if it was not already sponsored. You couldn't come in any building that was not already sponsored. So don't you see the illusion of going to get something for nothing doesn't exist? It's already pre-given by those who write it off as a tax deduction to allow those who stay there to administer the function of it. But
yes.
No one there gets any paid, because why? If they did get paid, they would have to pay income tax.
Uh-huh.
But they're allowed what is called the expense operation, through which they can purchase objects tax-free by the contribution offered by those who have already paid the tax as a deduction for giving it to
them. Yeah, and the rest of it, I'm not worried about the tax, I'm worried about the rest of the money.
There's no rest of the money, because everybody is accounted for rotational use of the operation of the thing. I've been in it, so if I hadn't been in it, I wouldn't have robot. I've been to the man who was my lawyer was the guy who was running for a district attorney when Mr. Nixon was in office. The district attorney of the whole country.
Oh.
And he put the laws very straight.
Yeah.
People have the erroneous notion that the church gets away with anything. The church doesn't get away with nothing.
No.
The point is this, is that the people who go to the church are the ones who benefit. The guy who can really say he's got something for nothing by being a figurehead is the Pope and the bishops. That's what they call them, princes of the church. They have to wear that expensive material and go around in that expensive
left brain is
big.
when you do the cross crawl or just crawling, that's just to balance your right brain, left brain. Right? And people that walk with both arms and legs on the same side together, they say they're usually imbalanced between their right and left brain. Is it true?
Not necessarily.
No? Because we were talking about how the pacers, they train those pacers from birth to walk that way. 2 feet on one side, one over, and then the other 2 feet. And the guy was saying that after generations of breeding those, that the colts start walking that way naturally. I was wondering if their brains were messed up from it. No. But that's not a natural gait.
You can train any creature to do anything.
But I was wondering if it would affect his health.
Naturally it would affect his health.
They would
die young.
That's what I thought.
Will they die young?
I don't know how old pacers live.
I know. You work with horses.
I've never been around pacers.
See how long you live.
Well, doesn't it affect their brain?
Well, this is where you gotta find out. How long they live. When you find out how long you live, then you'll find out something about what happened to their respiratory act. You live longer, a left-hander or a right-hander?
I guess a right-hander.
Why?
I don't know why, other than I just heard it was better to be right-handed.
It's not just guessing. Ascending side is the right side of the body, descending side is the left side of the body. And you write with the left side, what you do after a while to your body, you block it up.
Oh, you're writing with the descending side.
It's physics, it's not for a guess. Look at a thing objectively. This is what the body is. It's up this way, bumped up here all the time. Either we like it or we don't like it. There's certain qualities on the right side, not on the left side.
But just going like this is going to block you?
You are a machine. Common sense will tell you there is no compensation for the machine working incorrectly against its natural mechanics. We may fool ourselves and we would love to believe in all kind of crazy things only to end up the victim of stupidity and ignorance. To say that that person working on the left side is going to be superior than a person working on the right side. An ambidextrous person is a healthier person. But a right-handed person will be healthier than a left-handed person. All the time. Because left-handed people are frustrated and can't make decisions.
What causes that? Is it trauma at birth? Or before birth?
Yes, the trauma at birth.
What kind
of mother, the father left the mother. Or didn't want that to be responsible for the child. So basically you have the trauma right there.
Hmm.
The worst thing is that a man and a woman have sex and they can't have a child or they have a child. And they don't want to take responsibility for the child. Because who gets hurt?
The child.
Nothing like the child gets hurt.
Well, then the parents have to pay for it for a long time, too.
The parents are responsible in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
Because the sperm belongs to the man and the woman belongs to the woman. So they deserve what they get
from COVID.
I can't
change the motion picture challenge.
Limited.
There's a song you'd like to hear.
And I got a little bit frustrated with objective game. So if I'm going to work at therapy with people, I got to be objective about it.
Give me a call. 9 6 3
I got
to tell them what
they got to do.
That's what they call it, correct? But in that case, it seems like there'd be a lot of